You are ready as I am, would welcome the Member of Parliament for Korle, Klottey Constituency, Honourable Zanetor.
It's an honour to be here, and I stand here welcoming Her Excellency the First Lady and Deputy Minister and colleague, Your Excellency, the Ambassador for South Korea, as well as everybody else who's here. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, you're most welcome. It's an honor to be here, and indeed, as our MC mentioned, Osu could not be, you couldn't find a more perfect place than Osu to have a gallery like this. The Art Gallery Africa is in the right place. Osu is a place with a very rich history. Historically, we go all the way back to the slave trade. We have the Osu Castle, the Christian Ball Castle. We have the Art Center. The Nkrumah Mausoleum is also down the street. But also, we have lots of houses in Osu whose history goes way back to the slave trade and the colonial era, where you have people who are connected to the Danish, Swedish, you know, British, and other ancestry, as well as people who migrated here from Togo and other places in West Africa. I'm delighted to have been called upon to welcome you here today. It's wonderful to have the gallery located here, because all that we're trying to do is to bring more traffic to the Oxford Street. Oxford Street has a rich history of entertainment, of food, of art and culture. And this gallery is very well placed. Hopefully sometime in the near future, it will be a one-way system so that people can have ease of movement as they come in, and perhaps on some occasions, just a pedestrian pass so that people can actually enjoy the flavor of this place. Indeed, it's a pleasure to be here. If I may be so bold as to share my three words, I thought it was colorful, rich, and beautiful. Indeed, it's really lovely to be here, and I welcome you to the gallery. And on this occasion, I'd like to say that this is the place to be. So let's see how we can make Osu Oxford Street more vibrant by telling many people about this wonderful gallery. This gallery is to showcase the artists who are here. And we have lots of artisans on this street who have been begging for an opportunity to have their wares actually on display. And so we're hoping that if they keep the highest standards, some of their artwork will be displayed here and hopefully auctioned at amazing prices. Once again, I welcome you. God bless.
Thank you very much, Honorable. I remember those three words: color, colorful, rich, and beautiful. Thank you very much. I'm sure we have taken your three words, so in due course, I'll let you know what we'll do with the three words. Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to introduce the visionary, the man behind the project. Personally know him as a very hard-working Ghanaian. And I'm delighted at this point to welcome Mr. Kojo Choi. Please be able to go.
I'll be very brief because we are having an issue with heat. But as we are feeling the heat, I want us to feel the effort and hard work our artists go through every day. Because they actually, you know, paint an environment where such as this, and they spend hours. And let us feel today we've come on artists. So, Excellency, the First Lady of the Republic of Ghana, Rebecca Akufo-Addo, Honorable Zanetor-Rawlings, MP Klottey Korle, where we've all gathered here today, Mr. Yofi Grant, CEO of GIPC and also promoter of Art Africa, Korean Ambassador to Ghana, Mr. Jung-Taek, who is also a promoter of Art Africa. Ambassadors, distinguished guests, media, ladies and gentlemen, you are welcome. As a person born in Korea and later migrated to Ghana at an early age offered me two different perspectives in many various aspects. In Ghana, the word artist dominates against the word artist. Many still use artist to mean artiste, because our art and culture industry has become dominantly entertainment focused, because music and drama as an art has become widely received across the length and breadth of this nation. How sculptors and painters are left very little room to operate. I think it was in 1994 when I was a student at SOS College. Our class paid a visit to then Artist Alliance at Teshinubwa, with Beaufort on our right hand, with Yogo on the left hand. We paid a visit to a tour called, it was Body, Mind and Soul by one Mr. Kofi Setroji. My mind was thrilled. My mind was blown. The feelings I received from that tour that I had perhaps gave me the love for art at that tender age. Being an art lover and collector in the last decade, I realized that our arts lacked support systems and platforms which they needed to have them propelled to the world stage. I felt the strong need to create support systems and platforms that would give our artists the appropriate opportunities, hence the birth of Art Africa Foundation. Art Africa Foundation today is launching artafrica.net, which we plan to serve as the continental art platform. This digital art platform required us to give our presence a verifiable identity to lock in the needed credibility and trust. So the gallery you see here is our statement to the world, saying that we are for real and we mean business. So I present to you the Osu Gallery of Art Africa Foundation. Our goal is to extend our presence and footprints to all of Africa, starting from Ghana, as we attempt to serve the entire continent digitally and physically. We will run various programs and exhibitions to celebrate both our sung and unsung heroes. We will cooperate with international organizations and art galleries around the world in an attempt to showcase many talents of ours, which are long overdue. To achieve this, we need your support. We've gathered here to extend that needed support. Please purchase our paintings. Tell others about it and ensure they too purchase some. The paintings you buy today will totally transform your home and your emotions for better. In many places, your purchased art could value more than a plot of land. Owning a painting is not just a sentimental response to beauty, but also a cognitive response to increment opportunities. Please don't be in a hurry to leave when the program is over. Take your time to appreciate the works of some of the greatest children of our dear country. Let's have a lot of drinks and snacks, so don't feel pressured. Let's network and let's talk art. I'll be grateful if you could take some pictures wherever you are and hashtag and share your social media pages that you are at Africa Launch, and this will be one big support from you, even starting now. As I mentioned that my first exhibition in 1994 was themed Body and Mind, from which I had a lot of lessons from, I assure you that your each visit to Art Africa, of course, by then much cooler, much better, will be therapeutic to your mind and to your body. Therapeutic to your mind as you take your time and take your journey with paintings of different strokes, patterns, and colors. Therapeutic to your body as you'll find the best health products at the health corner back here, and also the beautiful natural flowers and skincare products at the downstairs. So it's a collective effort that we are trying to give you body and mind. I'd like to close my opening address by thanking God who made all things possible, even in a situation as this, I thank God. Lord, I thank you and I give you the glory. My thanks goes to all the artists, especially those present, whose perseverance brought our arts thus far. Thank you very much, you the artist. My thanks goes to my partners, patrons, friends, and families for trusting and supporting the visions I envision, especially my wife, Elizabeth. Finally, many thanks goes to Team Art Africa. Without you, there's no Art Africa. God bless Ghana. God bless Art Africa. Yami Shaw, all of you.
Thank you very much, Could you, I was very confident you were going to end with Chi. So that's okay. I'd like to acknowledge the South Korean ambassador to Ghana, Ambassador Jung-Taek. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we are honored to have the Deputy Minister for Trade and Industry, MSME and Domestic Trade. She's also the MP for Akuapem North. We'd like to take some remarks from her. Honorable Nana Maduku Asiamah-AdjeI. Let's welcome her with a round of applause.
Excellency, the First Lady of the Republic of Ghana, the Member of Parliament for Klottey, Korle, Klottey, Chief Executive Officer of the GIPC, Diplomatic Corps, distinguished invited guests, our gallant artists, members of the media fraternity, ladies and gentlemen, a good morning to us all. A good morning to us all. Thank you. On behalf of the Government of Ghana and the Honourable Minister of the Ministry of Trade and Industry, let me express my utmost gratitude and profound appreciation to the Arts Africa Ghana chapter for putting together this wonderful initiative and also for the invitation extended to us to join you at the launch of this great project. It is important to note that Ghana is the first country to host Arts Africa with its gallery located here at the Oxford Street. This indeed explains the enormous potential and opportunities Ghana presents globally in the world of arts. This is evident from the quality of our indigenous rhythmic Ghanaian music, painting, poetry, fashion, theatre, architecture, and the visual arts and design, amongst other arts. I'm also particularly happy about this initiative, considering the significance and importance of art in our society, our national development, and cohesion. The enlightenment and entertainment that the creative arts sector can bring will play an important role in local regeneration and enrichment of lives in our culture and communities. It will enhance the tourism sector of the country, as well as inspire education and the development of talent, innovation, and creativity among the younger generation. Distinguished guests, with Ghana positioning itself as a place to drive continental trade and a hub and dine of Africa's industrialization agenda, the arts industry has a special role to play in this regard. By working together as partners, Ghana's rich arts industry can be strategically positioned to anchor our industrialization drive. This will greatly increase our economic and social benefits, including higher capital spending, property values, educational resources, job creation, progress retail activity, increased tourism numbers, enhanced international visibility, cultural content production, community ownership, and cohesion. Arts is an important cultural and economic tool and has transformed a lot of economies. We can always look back and reflect on some of the world's leading arts festivals that draw the world together on common platforms. The Venice Biennale, the Biennale of Sydney, Hong Kong International Arts Fair, Whitney Biennale, Echigo Chumari Art Triennale in Japan, Vivid Sydney, the Paris Fashion Week, and a lot more are changing the economies of the countries these arts festivals are held in. I am convinced that as we have come together to launch this brilliant initiative, we will be able to engage and develop more of our youth who are embedded with enormous skills and talents in the area of arts. I will also implore our artists to also remain focused and disciplined and have mutual respect in this art industry. Let us not take it for granted. The cooperation and unity that exists between them will unlock several opportunities and openings before them. No man can do it alone. We need one another to succeed in this world of arts and every field we find ourselves in. As I conclude, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to reiterate the fact that art does not only inspire, it also sells. Art is not just for entertainment, it's a way of life. Art is not just for the fun of it, it's an expensive resource and therapeutic. We can also maximize its full potential by embarking on such great initiatives as this. Thank you, Arts Africa. I look forward to more of such exciting, fulfilling initiatives. I'm hoping you'll be considering Akuapem North for your very next location. God bless us all, and thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you very much, Deputy Honorable Minister. We'll definitely have the Akuapem North Chapter of Art Africa. Your Excellency, I would like to acknowledge the CEO of the Ghana Tourism Authority, Mr. Kwesi Agyeman. Can you give us a wave so that... Okay, he was spotted, so I'll continue. All right. Next, it's important that art doesn't just remain in our rooms, but the investment component of it is harnessed. And that is why it's important that we have the man who is the face of investment in Ghana, the CEO of the, for want of a better expression, the CEO of the Ghana Investment Promotion Center, the ever fashionable Mr. Yofi Grant. We are in an arts environment. True or not true?
Thank you very much. Your Excellency, the First Lady of the Republic, Mrs. Rebecca Akufo-Addo, my very good friend and MP for Akuapem North, MP for Korle, Klottey, my good friend, Zanetor, the Ambassador, let me see if I'll say it right, Nseyo. Thank you. And all the very distinguished ladies and gentlemen here, and people who appreciate art. For me, this is a very historic moment, because on this road, there's been a remarkable transformation of the city, of Accra, on the Oxford Street. And it continuously inspires and provokes new thinking, change and all. And so I congratulate you, Kojo. When he first spoke to me about this, that was before COVID. And we were seeing how we could work it together and the role that I should play. And unfortunately, I got so busy and so busy in quarantines and stuff, so we were not able to meet often to discuss it. But today we are here. And this offers a significant opportunity. As the MC said, art is not just for viewing's sake. Art represents culture. It represents the soul of a people. It represents a business opportunity. And it's not surprising that you have art pieces, one piece, being sold for hundreds of millions of dollars, because it tells a lot about who painted it, why he painted it, where he was. And as a country, we can't just do it without our art. We are a very cultural, colorful people in all ways. And so, Kojo, I'd like to congratulate you. But today, you are also privileged, I must say, to have in your midst a very important group from the United States of America. It's the Omega Sci-Fi group led by Dr. Marion. Many of you might not know who the... Many of you might not know who Omega Sci-Fi are, but it's an African-American fraternity that boasts quite a number of very, very prominent African-Americans, from Jesse Jackson, Michael Jordan, just name it. They're all part of it. And today, we actually managed to bring them here to see what's happening So if you could kindly all just wave, give us a little wave. And I believe this is the beginning of many things to come. Art is also business. I myself am a collector of art. I'm a photographer. Some of the things that I want to do, I actually, at some point, was getting a commission to do 3 photo books for Ghana by Tashin, the biggest publisher of photo books. But, life happens and you move on to other things. But that, it doesn't end there. I'd also like to say that this transformation of Oxford Street is not going to end with this one. And maybe I should let you know, the MP, I'm on a project to convert the Osu Night Market into an art walkway. It's going to require, it's not a very expensive endeavor, it's going to be just $250,000. But I want it to be crowdfunded so that everybody is part of it. It could have been done long ago, but I thought, no, let the people own it, let the people do it. As a testament of living the life in Accra. And so, Kojo, I think you probably ignited a certain art revolution, which will keep growing and developing. But also beyond that, as I was telling my friends from the United States not too long ago, Ghana is so well positioned. Ghana is a country in the center of the world. We are the only country on latitude zero, longitude zero. So we have a 360 degree view of the world. And it's just not about our cocoa, our gold, our timber, our lithium, etc., etc. In recent times, Ghana is fast being acknowledged as also a center of culture. And so with the year of return and beyond the return, we have almost inadvertently become a sort of, in quote, a mecca for the African in the diaspora and anybody of African descent. But not just African. There are many countries who have at some point or the other passed through Ghana. The Portuguese, the Dutch, the German, the French, the Danish, and then lastly the English. And they all feel a part of Ghana. And that is a testament to the art we see today, because there are many influences. Although very cultural and very traditional, you will see a lot of other influences in the art. And so let's all embrace this. Like Kojo said, you can look at the pictures, but own a piece. Own a piece of Africa in your home. It's not just furniture we bring from other parts of the world that should be in our sitting rooms. A bit of our culture and our heritage should be in our sitting rooms. And so I'd urge you, as you see these very marvelous pieces, maybe you buy it today for, who knows? The important is how much it will be worth tomorrow. And so I would like to say a warm welcome on behalf of Kojo and my sincere gratitude for him for opening your eyes. I mean, when you see Kojo walking far away and somebody tells you, where does he come from? We say, oh, this man, he's Asian, he's from Korea. I can assure you, he's more Ghanaian than I am. So thank you very much. I mean, if you see a man and then his name is Kojo, you say, oh, where did he get the Kojo from? He's got me right here. He's Ghanaian. So thank you very much, and we wish you well, and we'll keep supporting you every time.
Thank you very much, Mr. Yofi Grant. Always refreshing to hear from you. He says, own a piece of Africa in your home. So that must stay with us. Your Excellency would like to express art in a different way, and to help us do that, we have Ima Ofosua to do a poetry recital. Can we appreciate him?
A warm good morning to you, standing on all protocols already established. I'm going to do something fairly different. This is spoken word, and when you came in, you were asked to write words on a sheet of paper, and so this is freestyle, as is art. It is not scripted, and so I'm going to dip in any word that any sheet that I pick. I'll pick the first of 3 copies, and then I'll create something with it in the moment. So I'll definitely work with your colorful.
Thank you.
color here, so I'm going to skip that and pick a lot more. And I'm accompanied by Nenena on strings. Okay, so this is a good pick. I have a wide range of words to work with here. And I'm going to work with the landlady's first word, which is colorful. I'm going to work with impressive, which is the first word someone wrote down here. And I'm going to work with emotional. I'm sure other words may find their way in there, but do enjoy this one. So tell me, how do I capture the very essence of life in a 2 minute time capsule? How do I tell the histories of a people with words in limitation? And as we struggle to find a stable source of lighting, I contemplated and it struck me. In more ways than one, it struck me that to do and achieve this seemingly unsurmountable height, we must revert to art. Otherwise, how else will we tell a people's histories and their stories, capture their hearts, their tales, their tears, and their pains? Tell the rich cultural values that embody their very essence, if not on canvases. Every first experience with anybody is an invitation to access a black canvas on their, in the galleries of their minds. And every impression you make is an expression on this black canvas. And so what will your story be after we have all encountered you today? What will we walk away with, reminiscent of your very provenance? We are in a space that captures the that captures art of African provenance, and these stories remain the root of our origin as a people. And so I entreat you to witness colorful, impressive brush strokes on canvases walled along these galleries. I entreat you to make sure that the very experiences we are carried along on this journey does not only stay here, but goes with us to our homes. If African artists carry the very heart of Africa in their brush strokes and with every colorful splash, then the warm, welcoming tones that are seen on these canvases will be an exemplary example of what we as a people stand for. And so tell me again, how do I capture the essence of a people, their origin, in a 2 minute time capsule? I will revert to the very artist that represents the warmth, carries us through the emotions, communicates the expressions, takes us through heartwarming tales of colorful, vibrant cultural experiences of the people that I am yet to meet. Go with them on a journey to worlds I am yet to encounter. Storm into marketplaces that otherwise I may not have the opportunity to go to. Dance to tunes and rhythms from cultures I may never experience. And yet, fish along the coast on these canvases, because in one space, I was given the opportunity to explore all of Ghana and Africa on these canvases. Thank you.
Oh, I think I keep applauding.
Wow, that is great. That is impressive. Thank you very much, Imaofusua. Ladies and gentlemen, I recall that in 2019, she said it was her dream to see the nation's capital, Accra, become the hub for artists on the continent of Africa.
as artistic work has the potential to draw tourists to Ghana and to help the country earn more valuable income. Ladies and gentlemen, I really remember where and when she said this. And today we are honored to have in our midst the First Lady of the Republic of Ghana, Her Excellency Rebecca Akufo-Addo. Shall we all rise as we welcome our First Lady here and take her in. The keynote address.
Thank you. Honorable Zanetor Agyeman-Rawlings, Yofi Grant of GIPC, His Excellency the Korean Ambassador, Management of Art Africa Gallery, distinguished guests, distinguished artists, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. The creation and appreciation of art is universal across continents, cultures, and classes. A piece of artwork is created by an individual or individuals and then becomes an object of both intellectual and emotional appreciation for other people. I cannot imagine society without the influence of art, because art connects us to us at a very personal level. A good piece of artwork can give pleasure to many who truly appreciate art. It can produce a narrative that tells us about times past, about civilizations, about the artist, and how he sees our world. I like to think that art does not discriminate or limit us. Each of us is free to appreciate a piece of work in our own way. My love affair with art was born when, as a young woman, I learned to love and appreciate the artwork displayed in my parents' home. This love affair has never waned. And that is why I have always seen art and artists as integral to life. They reflect the vibrancy, hues, intricacies, energy, and mysteries of nature. They set us on a path of discovery and wonder. I have spent a lifetime collecting artistic pieces from all over the world, but nothing gives me more pleasure than artwork from my beloved Ghana. So for me, it is a delight to be part of the launch of Art Africa Gallery. But art goes beyond the individual's experience. Art gives nations very distinct identities and has great economic value, both for the artists and those who buy their works. I believe every country owes it to its citizens to support and promote artistic works and talents. I want to express my appreciation of artists like Larry Otu, Abladi Glover, and others who have given art a positive image. They have taught us that art is as much a part of Ghana's economy as well as its heritage. I particularly applaud their hard work, which has birthed this beautiful initiative called Art Africa. It is my expectation that we will have more of our accomplished artists mentoring younger artists, holding their hands, and creating legacies that will live on for generations. We have seen many great painters and painters from other continents. It is now our turn, Africa's turn, to showcase what we have with the rest of the world. God bless us all, and God bless Art Africa. I thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We have beautiful pieces that is donated to Brother Rebecca Akufo-Addo's foundation. Wow. This is coming from nobody but our own Glover, Professor Glover, Abelardo Glover. This is coming from nobody but our great uncle Larry Otu. Please stand there, take photo. So we will give a big round of applause for Madam, Excellency, and also the donors. Thank you very much, Madam.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Your Excellency.